Hello there, guys. Welcome to another Train Simulator video. I know this is a bit late and kind of ridiculous that I'm making this video now. I wanted to make it several days ago, but I was a bit busy. So anyway, I got it now. This is a pack by the guys over at dieselworks.net. I will link their site where you can grab these down below, but it's a bicentennial kind of paint and slight sound pack that they created for the holiday we recently had, 4th of July, of course. There's two engines in this pack. The one we're looking at here, of course, is the Norfolk and Western SD 45 1776. A lot of these were built back in 76 when, of course, it was the bicentennial. And that's what you see here. The SD-45s, they were built between 65 and 71. They had a 645 E3 20-cylinder engine putting out about 3,600 horsepower. This one here, you see, is obviously the 1776 livery. This train in real life, or locomotive, sorry, is on display at the Roanoke Railroad Museum currently. So that'd be cool to see that thing in real life. But this model is, of course, the DTM SD-45, which, in my very humble opinion, is one of DTM's better locomotives. I thoroughly enjoyed this thing when I got it. It is very old, but as far as like the way it sounds and how it looks, it's not that bad considering some of the other DTM stuff. But that's besides the point. Anyway, we're going to check this thing out. It's got a miniaturized Liberty Bell on the short hood, which of course is right here. It's pretty clean, I gotta say. The numbering is pretty good. Here's your bell. Miniature Liberty Bell, of course. So yeah, thing looks pretty cool, man. So they put a custom horn and bell on these. Now, I know a little bit about horns and bells. I'm not a horn and bell nut. This one sounds highly interesting. I have no clue what it is. If you do, please let me know in the comments below. But we'll give it a blast from a distance here. It's an interesting sounding horn. We'll hide in the bushes. And it's got Doppler, so the farther you get, the different, you know, noises you get. Closer you get, of course, the same. That thing sounds terrifying. That's kind of cool. I have no freaking clue what that horn is, though. It sounds pretty damn cool, though. I like it. But anyway, yeah, this was painted during 1976 and the bicentennial craze. Just about every American railroad painted, you know, something to do with this. Especially, now that I think of it, I think Canada did one as well. But they were cool, man. There was a lot of good-looking stuff. And this being an old EMD, you know, SD-45, high nose, kind of funky as is, but it looks good. Let's check that bell out. So they did a good job on the sound department, for sure. So yeah, that is your Norfolk and Western 1776. I'd love to see this thing in real life. It was cool that they honored the bicentennial with stuff like this. It's because you don't see stuff like this nowadays. You know, it's all company branded, just bleh, for the most part. But anyway, that one's cool. My favorite, easily favorite out of the pack, is this puppy sitting over here. The, well, you can call it Crip. Sounds kind of gangstery calling it Crip, but it's the Chicago Rock Island and Pacific. E8 652, and this thing looks pretty darn good. I love the way this thing looks. It looks very, very crispy. It too obviously was a bicentennial unit. It's at the Iowa Northern Railway, I think, but it's no longer in the paint, sadly, because this thing looks amazing. That's a damn shame, though, that it's not in the paint. The E8 really needs no introduction. They built them in the late 40s, 49 through 54, I think. It had the EMD 567B prime mover with a V12 two-stroke, which just were awesome engines, and pumped out about 2,200 some odd horsepower. But it too has got the custom Horman bell, recreation of the decals, true to life design and color, as they say per their website. But you get both of these as part of the pack. You can download them separately if you like. Of course, I went and grabbed both of them. It's pretty neat. I hate that this is way past the 4th, what, 3 days later. But like I said, I would have gotten to this had I could earlier. But, you know, you can still run them. Still have them for next year anyway. Got the Don't Tread on Me logo up there. 20th Century Railroad Club. EMD decal. I just love the colors on this thing, man. Something about that blue and red and white. And the Rock, of course. The Rock, the cool railroad, great logo. They financially were pretty garbage, but you know, that's usually how it goes with certain railroads. It's usually the crummy ones that people seem to like the most, but anyway, we'll hop in here. But everything else works the same as far as I can tell. Nothing has been changed physics or sound-wise, aside from the horn and the bell. Now, it does have a little bit of a loop, as you heard there. It's, let's see. Probably about 2 seconds. So as long as you're under about 2 seconds, it's not really noticeable. But sometimes it sounds a little bit different between, you know, keystrokes. So I don't know what's... But it's good with that quick blast, you know. There's no real problems there. Just want to see how far we can get here. That's nuts, man. They got that spot on. That sounds amazing. I think that sounds downright demonic up close, though. There's like a certain area. That's nuts, though. But yeah, your Rock Island 652 E8, also a bicentennial unit. But yeah, just wanted to make a quick video of these for, you know, just having a quick look and go and listen at them. Again, by the guys over at dieselworks.net. They got a couple of cool things over there, so I'd recommend going checking them out, seeing if anything tickles your fancy. But these units look great, and it's a shame this one here is no longer, you know, adorned in this skin. But dude, that big star on the front, just the side profile of this thing, looks absolutely awesome. But yeah, that's it, just a quickie. Go and check these out if you think you might like to have them in your locomotive arsenal. But that's it, guys. Thanks for watching and checking them out. I'll see you next time, guys. Take care. Bye.